We couldn't arrest him at that time just because we didn't have a positive identification from a victim.
All right, looks like he's going to pull into another hotel parking lot.
But there was something they could do.
Go ahead and conduct a traffic stop on that red Ford Explorer.
Remember, the vehicle had no license plate, so the undercover team called in a marked patrol car. Using the missing plates as an excuse, uniformed officers pulled the suspect over.
Is he a driver's license registration?
He had to hand over his driver's license. Now, cops finally knew who he was.
Gacho Emanuel, V-E-I-G-A.
Emanuel Carlos Veiga, a Brazilian citizen, here in the States on a work visa. After getting a citation, Veiga drove off with no idea he was being trailed. Meanwhile, armed with the picture from his driver's license, detectives quickly arranged a photo lineup for several victims. Carla, the teenager who was attacked in the YMCA parking lot, knew right away they had the right guy.
Is this the guy?
That's him.
No doubt in your mind?
No doubt in my mind. That is him.
The positive ID gave police what they needed. Veiga was charged with kidnapping a child, sexual battery, lewd and lascivious molestation, and rape.
I'm glad that I could be the one to put him behind bars. Well, he was.
That's right, was, but isn't anymore. A judge, Carolyn Freeman, decided it would be safe to place Veiga on house arrest with a monitoring device attached to his ankle. Judge Freeman has refused to publicly comment on the case, but her decision stunned the team of detectives who'd worked so hard to take an accused predator off the street.
All the hard work we put in for the judge to sit there and say she finds it more important for him to run his family business than all the innocent victims that he's taken care of? Come on, that's ridiculous.
Ridiculous and a big, big mistake. 6 weeks after being allowed to go home, Veiga cut off his monitoring device and walked away. He hasn't been seen since.
Here are the clues that can track this creep down. Veiga made his living cleaning newly made homes and maybe working as a janitor. He's an avid surfer and has always lived close to the water. He spends a lot of time at the gym working out. And he's into martial arts. He's competed in jiu-jitsu tournaments since he was a kid. If you know where Emanuel Veiga is hiding, call our hotline at 1-800-CRIME-TV.
Now this story absolutely drives me nuts. Veiga committed a serious, serious crime, and the judge treats it like he's some kind of solid citizen. When are the people in charge going to take these sex offenders seriously? Earlier this month, it was revealed that pedophiles on parole in California were being housed by the state in motels just blocks from Disneyland. Motels filled with kids on vacation with their families. How could that happen? Well, at least there's something we can do. Help cops track down Emanuel Veiga one more time. So if you've seen Veiga or know where he's hiding, please stand up and do the right thing. Call our hotline right now. Now stay with us. We'll be right back.
One year ago this week, Natalee Holloway disappeared in Aruba.
A judge ordered three suspects to be held in custody.
You may think you know the story, but later tonight, you'll hear for the first time from someone who was there when it happened.
For the first 2 months after the trip, I would wake up crying, having nightmares after it, and the flashbacks would just be so vivid. It was just so hard to even deal with.